take this video out of context, chop it up, manipulate it. I don't give a f- anymore.
One of the best things that was ever said to me was, I'm sorry for everything that you've ever been through, but it's no longer an excuse to live the way that you're living. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health. And what I try to do is pull different topics from the YouTube community to try to teach you how to improve your mental and emotional well-being. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And yeah, for all of you Rewired soldiers out there who are familiar with my setup, obviously this is different. And if you're wondering why, you haven't been paying attention. I'm in California right now. I'm actually at my dad's house. My dad's sitting right behind the camera over there. I told him to be quiet while I'm recording. But yeah, so somebody sent me a tweet over on Twitter. Well, that's where you get tweets. And it's from Steph. So thank you, Steph, for recommending this. She was like, yo, have you seen the new Veronica Wang video? And I had like, So many of you asked me to, you know, make videos about the Veronica Wang situation and all of that, and I'm, you know, nowhere near the mukbang community, so I didn't really get into it or research it or anything like that. Like, at the end of the day, I've commented on this before over on Twitter, like, we're pretty much at a point where, like, the community is just about never going to side with a creator if they copyright strike somebody. Like, you just recently saw it again with Manny MUA. We're gonna see this happen over and over and over again. Like, if it's a legitimate copyright strike, like, cool, but that's very rare. Very, very rare, all right? This new video, I was watching it, well, listening to it rather, as I was driving here to California, and I was like, dang. So, Veronica Wang, if there's any chance that you happen to see this video, if you would like, I left a comment on your video, feel free to reach out, DM me, email me. I'm at The Rewired Soul on Instagram or Twitter. I'm gonna use this video to kind of explain how I can relate to a lot of what Veronica was going through. So Veronica, if you see this, I'll send you a free copy of my book. But anyways, for those of you who are new here, I don't make these videos for the YouTubers, even though my channel is getting bigger and more YouTubers are seeing my videos. This video is for you. So I know a lot of you struggle with anger issues, and I know a lot of you who've been following me for the last couple months, you're like, oh dang, Chris, quit plugging your book, Rewire Your Anger. Well, Veronica Wang's situation is exactly why I wrote this book, because so many people deal with this stuff, all right? So anyways, I wanna break this thing down and talk about my experience and give you some tips that might be able to help you out.
Like, people get upset with me for showing a little bit of anger. Yeah, I have a little anger in me. Like, that's what happens when you grow up in the f***ing hood. You always have a little bit of anger in you. That's just the way it is. And I try not to be angry. That's the thing. I try to be happy and positive. And I am, for the most part.
Right there, Veronica was talking about, like, if you understood the way that I grew up, you'd understand why I was so angry. Like, I had to be angry in order to survive. Like, girl, I get it, okay? So one of the issues that a lot of us struggle with is something that we call terminal uniqueness, right? We think that nobody else on earth can possibly understand what we're feeling. Like, I get it. That's how I used to be. I thought, like, you don't understand what I've been through. So although our situations, like, might be different in some circumstances, right, the feelings that we felt are the same, okay? So what Veronica is explaining, what it seems like, and this is a conversation I would have Veronica if she was one of my friends, but I'm having this conversation with you since you're one of my viewers. I would be like, listen, this is a coping skill that people like you and I developed, right? This is something that I developed as a child. I was a very angry dude growing up. I had so many anger issues, which is one of the reasons why I had to write a book about how I manage this today. But back then, this was a coping skill, and something that's so important for all of us when we're looking at our coping skills, like, we use these things to survive. But as we get older, we need to really take a step back, look at our life, and ask ourselves, is this coping skill still of value to me? Is it still useful to me today? Today, in my present situation, is the way I react and respond to situations useful? So, looking at Veronica Wang's situation, no, clearly not, because she did something out of anger, all right? So, before I move forward, I want you all to be able to separate reasons from excuses. Like, I can already see it now just because I've been around the community long enough and read enough comments to know. I know a lot of people are gonna come at Veronica and say you're making excuses for your behavior, all right? And like, for Veronica or for any of you out there, like, it's a reason, but it's not an excuse, okay? So, like, if she's using this as an excuse, I don't know. I don't know her. I don't know what her intention is, even though a lot of people are going to assume they know her intention. I'm not going to. But we need to realize, like I said in the intro of this video, like, a lot of us have been through stuff, but it's no longer an excuse to act the way that we act, right? Like, those of you who have followed my channel long enough, you know, rule number one is don't be a dick, all right? So if we can go back to that golden rule, we're gonna be just fine.
Okay, I need to chill out. I'm so sorry that I'm, like, angry, but, like, I have all the right to be. I don't care what anyone says. You shouldn't be angry. You shouldn't be. Bitch, yes, I have the fucking right to. I do not care. I have the right to be angry about this situation. It's been a fucked up situation for me.
That right there. This is what people get twisted. And this is actually a chapter I wrote in my book. Like, yes, Veronica Wang does have a right to be angry. She has every right to be angry. Like, anger is a very valid emotion. It's something I try to teach you guys, is that nobody on earth can tell you that your experience is not valid, okay? We're humans. We deal with emotions, the good and the bad. So yes, in these situations, your anger is valid, okay? You have a right to be angry, but you do not have the right to lash out on people. Let me repeat that for everybody, okay? You have a right to be angry, but you don't have a right to lash out on people. Now, I get it if you guys understand what I've been talking to you about, the amygdala and the prefrontal cortex and all that jazz with your brain. Like, during moments of anger where we're lashing out, we feel very justified, okay? So, something I haven't talked about, which maybe I'll talk about more in other videos more in depth. I used to be a very vengeful person, right? Like, you screw me, I'm gonna screw you over 10 times worse, right? Like, that's the way a lot of our brains work. It makes us feel justified. So in Veronica Wang's situation, she felt justified because she was going through so much stuff people don't know, and it built up to a point where she made this decision to copyright strike, who was it, Shookbang, all right? And that's the thing, when we get angry, we feel justified. But something else that I was actually just talking to my dad about, that I wrote in this book too, there's a whole chapter on apologizing. And let me say this, like, we have to apologize, which Veronica Wang did, but if you're like me, I hate apologizing. I absolutely hate apologizing. So here's my pro tip. If you hate apologizing for stuff, quit doing stuff that makes you have to apologize to people. Now, the last thing that I want to talk about is this, and I don't know Veronica, I don't know what she's going through, so this is more advice to you, okay? Like, Veronica Wang said many times, like, I'm trying, and what we saw in this video is that she does not have it under control. She was extremely angry in this video. Like, I was like, oh my lord.
Bitch, the reason why I woke up every day at 5 a.m. in the morning.
Like, that's one of the reasons why I offered her a copy of my book, because here's the thing, watching that video, here's my biggest fear for Veronica Wang, as well as all of you who aren't getting your anger under control. It's going to happen again, okay? Like, we really need to sit back and ask ourselves, like, what is my definition of trying, right? I hear so many people saying, I'm trying. Like, I work in addiction treatment, okay? I hear people saying, I'm trying to stay sober. I'm like, what is your definition by trying, right? Are you going to meetings? Are you going to therapy? Are you doing medically assisted treatment? What are you doing? Are you working 12 steps? Are you talking to a support group? What are you doing? What does trying mean? Like, if we're just trying, but we're not taking any active steps towards our recovery or towards our anger management, towards our, you know, depression, towards our anxiety, towards recovering from our trauma, then what does trying really mean? So when I see her in this video, once again, reminding everybody that she apologized for this one situation, but seeing how much anger that she still holds inside of her, my fear is that this is going to happen again. Like, you guys, we get into the same cycles, okay? One of my favorite quotes is this, if nothing changes, nothing changes, okay? Like, if we don't change anything, we are doomed to repeat it again. I hate to say it, and this is, you know, again, this isn't for Veronica, this is for you. Like, you guys, life is going to slap you right in the face. And the problem with life is, it doesn't give you warning. Life isn't like, hey, next week, something very terrible is gonna happen to you. Like, wouldn't that be convenient? Wouldn't it be so convenient if life just like sent you a text message and was like, hey Chris, next week your car's gonna break down, right? It's not gonna do that to me, right? So if I don't actively work on my mental health and prepare for it, what happens is, I'm gonna snap, right? We eventually get put under so much pressure and we can only hold so much, and then we finally just, poof, we snap. And I know Veronica talked a lot about, you know, people have these ideas of YouTubers and what they should be and how they should act and stuff like that. And it's like, no, I don't put this expectation on YouTubers. I put this expectation on everybody, right? I don't care who you are. Like, some people get it twisted and they're like, oh, well, you know, that kid's just a kid. Like, if you're 17, 18 years old, you're old enough to take responsibility for your actions. Like, let me put it this way. If you go to court and a judge can make the decision to try you as an adult, you are old enough to start taking responsibility for your actions. I'll say it, all right? But anyways, again, like, if you struggle with anger issues, if you can relate, check out the description, pick up a copy of Rewire Your Anger, or do something else, seek therapy, or whatever you gotta do, or you're doomed to repeat the past, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And if you would like to become a patron, you can click or tap right there, all right? Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.